Goodbye, little fishy. I don't want you to think that I don't love you, because I do. But you'll be safer in there. And maybe you'll be adopted by some big fish. Be a good fish, Harold, and pray to St. Francis for me, and I'll do the same for you.
Are you sure you want to do that, little girl? That pond is full of big bass, you know. They might make a meal out of Harold. I'd wait till he's grown a little.
I was just looking for a home for him.
Well, what's the matter with your own?
I have none. I'm an orphan.
Oh?
I burned down the convent.
You did?
But it wasn't a sin because it was an accident.
Well, I'm sure it was.
Harold and I and the rest have to find new homes. And some of them did. But I haven't yet. And Edward hasn't either.
Edward?
A boy. He's still with us on the train.
Oh.
I don't like to say it, but he's an unpimpled liar. He said he would eat Harold. So that's why I wanted him to be safe somewhere, and that's why I came here.
Why do you call the little fish Harold?
Oh, I named him after those angels. Hark the herald angels sing.
And what's your name?
Patsy. What's yours?
Victoria McChesney.
How do you do?
How do you do? Well, aren't you going to eat your lunch?
Oh, will you have some?
No, thanks. Well, thank you.
What's in the basket?
Mushrooms. I've been picking them. I'm quite good at it.
Oh. There are 14 of us left. Those of us who don't find mothers and fathers along the way are going to Manitoba and the Indians.
Well, I'm told that Manitoba's quite nice. And the Indians are very friendly. But what do you mean about mothers and fathers along the way?
We're all of us on a train, and we're being given to whoever wants us. The train is right there in the station. It stopped for an hour.
You see, there are just 14 of you left.
The best ones were taken first, of course.